Tell us about fully autonomous trucks by 2025. That feels really bold to me.
Yeah, it's bold, but at the same time, it's something that, it's the next milestone for the company, where thanks to the generative AI technology, we are able to go so much faster and so much more capital efficient compared to the rest of the industry. Today, we have trucks driving autonomously in Texas with a safety driver, really, really performant. And we are at the verge of really enabling level four deployment without a human. And this is a very exciting day for Waabi today.
So tell us about ultimately what the difference is that you have pioneered. I understand it's a single end-to-end AI system that basically has human-like reasoning. Why is that so important for autonomous trucks?
Yeah, so I spent the last 2 decades really trying inventing technology, AI technology, to bring this idea of a single AI system that is able to reason like a human does, so that it can really generalize to all the different situations that might happen on the road, because we will never be able to observe everything prior to deployment. And these reasoning abilities is remarkable in terms of adding an extra layer of safety compared to anything else that we have seen in the industry. One way to think about it is that, we have this system that can be, works by perceiving the world, creating interpretable abstractions, and then uses those abstractions to reason about what is the best, from all the possibilities of the things that it can do, what is the best maneuver. And that's much safer, much more efficient than anything that we've seen before. And it's provably safe. So we have solved the alignment problem in AI, which is very important to bring this technology to the physical world.
I mean, as you've mentioned, you've been basically at the forefront of AI and applications in the real world for 2 decades. You applied some of that know-how to Uber, and you're now already sort of working alongside Uber when it comes to trialing autonomous on the roads of Texas. And they're backing you in this particular fundraise as well. What gets you from trial, error, to actually it functioning by 2025? Does regulation have to change, Raquel?
So the regulatory framework, particularly in Texas, where we're going to launch, enable us to deploy this technology. And we are working with all the regulatory bodies, really in a day-to-day basis, so that they can understand our technology with the trust. And for the first time, we have the ability to really make a much more robust safety case compared to the rest of the industry, which is trying to crank up miles in order to have a way to prove safety. But those miles are not sufficient, right? If you look at the rate of events on highways, a severe injury will happen every 10 million miles, and death on the road is every 100 million miles or the sub magnitude. So you need something different. And thanks to Waabi World, our generative AI simulator, for the first time, we have a way to prove safety in a scientific, mathematical way. And that's something that the regulators really appreciate, as finally having the ability to really certify systems in a much better way than the industry is today. So they're very excited about what we are building. And as I said, we bring them alongside and build trust from day one.
So when everyone's trying to poke holes in Elon Musk's idea of robo-taxis coming in a year or so, with the August the 8th date hot in many investors' minds, do you think that that can be a reality? And ultimately, we can be seeing autonomous vehicles more broadly, whether it's trucking or cars or robo-taxis, by 2025?
I would say that we will see in the end-to-end other types of approaches that you see in the industry today for level two, level three, which is not fully autonomous systems. The problem with those approaches is that they are black box architectures. They are not interpretable. They are very difficult to validate and verify, and they require massive amount of data and compute to be trained. And it's not scalable either, like the previous generation of technology, AV 1.0 with the hand engineer approach. So we need something better, and that's what we have with Waabi, this new generation of foundational models, that they are really purposely built for the physical world, so that you can really deploy safely this technology in a way that has superhuman capabilities. So we will see, in the next, months or years to come. But what is very clear is that self-driving is going to happen, and the scaling will happen first in trucking. That's why, this is our first use case. But Waabi is going to do so much more than just self-driving trucks. So humanoids, warehouse robotics, all those different use cases would be something that we will target in the future.